Welcome to Analytics with Nax. This is the first video in 2024 and I'm going to actively post videos in this year. With this note, let's begin our first topic in 2024, that is personalization or personalize your visual in Power BI. And what it is basically, like, once you publish your reports in Power BI, when you are a report reader, or this particular report is embedded in some other applications, the users cannot able to change any other chart type. The charts are very fixed, and if they want to change it, there is no way right now. So once you enable this personalization visual or personalized visual, then user can have a ability to change any of the chart types. That is the personalized visual is all about. And this feature is closely related to perspective concept in BI world, and that is what we are going to enable as well. And how it is related, we will see as part of the demo. So basically, personalized visual enables you to change the visualization type, swap out measures, dimension, add or remove legends, compare two or more measures, and change aggregations. And I can say it is a self-servicing BI. So yeah, I have made video on the self-servicing BI. Just check about it. What do you mean by that? So it will enable the users to analyze themselves. That is what a self-servicing BI is all about. And this channel content, free content that covers Power BI, MS BI, SQL Server, and interview preparations as well. Utilize this free content, share this channel with friends and colleagues. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin our today's topic. What I mean by that? So I'm in Power BI service now, and this is the simple report I have published here. Right now, if you see here, when I click on a certain visual or filters, it will filter, and there is no way the users can able to change this visual, right, within this visual. And you might have asked me, it's a edit button. This is the I have edit rights, and that's why I have this option. I'm not talking about this edit option. Assume he is the report reader and this report is embedded somewhere, right? They can see only this part of this report in that application. So if the user wants to change, let's say he is seeing this year, right? He wants to see the month as well. How can he do it? He cannot do it right now. So this is the, I mean, right now he has a drill through, they can do it. Let's say he, instead of this year, he wants to see some other dimension by product, right? That is not possible right now. Even this visual, he wants to see by territory. Instead of territory, he wants to see underneath. There is no levels, there is no hierarchy involved. You can see here. Now it's in sales territory country. He wants to see what are the different cities of it. He can't able to do right now. It's more or less a fixed. So when we enable personalization visual, users can able to edit these visuals on their own, and whatever analysis they can do, they can change any of this x-axis, y-axis, and different measures as well. That is what all about. Let's try to understand how to do it and where we can enable these options. So I'm in my Power BI desktop now. So this visual, I mean this page, doesn't have a personalization yet. Now you can enable the personalization visual at the page level or at the individual visual level. First of all, in order to enable this option, you need to enable the personalization visual feature in the options button. So go to this report settings, and that is option called personalize visuals. So this is the option available. You need to check it. I have already made that one. That's why it's appearing right now. Let's try to enable this one And right now you can see there is a edit button available. This visual can be personalized by the report readers. This visual can be personalized by the report readers. Even this one can be personalized. But I don't want certain visuals to be changed by the users. Only charts they can use. So you can disable at the chart level. So click on this visual and go to general, header icons, and expand icons again. Then there is option called personalization visual. Just disable it. So only for this visual I disabled. For all other visuals, enable it. So I'm just showing you the option how to enable at the page level and how to disable at the visual level. So this is the one thing I want to highlight. Now let me publish this visual. Once I publish this, and we go back to our Power BI services and refresh page. Let us see it's published or not. Only if it's published, we will get the result. Okay, let's refresh once again. There you go. Right now, there is an option over here to personalize. You can see here, this personalize. This visual is disabled. That's why you are not getting it. So let's try to change this visual. As I said, even you can change the chart type. Instead of this, I want a column chart now. And instead of that sales territory country, I want the region. You can see. And I can add, actually, I can add any other things. Even in legend, I can add right now by region, and I can split by country now. So you can see how it behaves, right? Differently. So I can able to personalize the entire visual. So I can remove it. I don't like that one. So this is what I'm talking about. So this is the personalized visual. So there is an option for you to bookmark this as well. Capture this report under current state, and you can share this visual with your colleagues as well. This is the another important option. So this is about your personalized visual. It will enable you, the report readers, also play around with different perspective of the charts. It will not affect for all other users. This is only for that particular user, whoever is editing or personalizing for him. So coming back to our desktop, and I told about perspective, right? What do you mean by that? When I expand this visualization, I mean at the general personalization visual, you can see report reader perspective. Basically, perspective is concept underlying layer of the model. Okay, and right now you can see the entire model as the perspective. What I am trying to say is, like, you have entire data set here, and the same model is exposed to the report readers here. Once you edit it, you can see here I can change the chart type, and also in order to add certain columns, the entire model is exposed. So sometimes if it is a very complex model, if you expose entire data set, people will get confused. So you can create a subset of this model and then only expose that perspective with this personalization visual. So once you create perspective, this will be displayed. So you can choose that perspective to be published for the report personalization. So how to do that? For that, to create a perspective, we need to go to Tabular Editor. Then here is option perspective. I can say like product and region perspective. What we need to do is go to this and enable show in perspective. Okay, product region. Either you can enable a single column as well, or you can enable the entire table in that perspective. So for time being, I am enabling what you call two dimension here perspective. Even you can create another perspective like customer and date. So I think a date should be part of both perspective. Show in all perspective. It says all perspective. I'm not sure it will reflect in both the perspectives. Let's try to check. Otherwise you need to add manually, like show in perspective, customer region and everything. So let's save this one and close it. So let's collapse this one and go to other page and come back, because usually this will not reflect. There you go. So this is the issue in Microsoft. When you create a perspective, it will not immediately reflect here. You need to close and reopen it. Let's try to close and reopen it again. I'm opening it again from the desktop. Be with me for a few seconds. It is little slow. As you aware, Power BI is always slow unless you don't have a very good RAM. I have a very decent RAM, around 16 GB or 32 GB, I'm not sure. Maybe it's time for me to upgrade. Okay. Now we are back to our perspective. I'm in this summary page right now. Let's go here and I enable it. You can check it out. I created two perspectives here. Let me choose product region, right? And then I can publish this to the services. So let's rename, overwrite it. So before it get refreshed, let me show you. See, right now I have different fields, right? The entire data set is displayed and I'm publishing right now. Let me refresh the report. So I should see very limited columns, that is a subset of the model, to be available to the report author. So I refreshed it. So let me go and check. You can see, because I have used the subset of your data called product region. This is not available to the end user to change. So right now I can choose color. By color I can choose remove field. So only with these fields the user can able to analyze now. So this is the very important feature, the known feature in analytics world, which is called a perspective, which is nothing but subset of your model. And by default, the entire model is one of the perspective, which includes all the columns. I hope you are clear with what you mean by personalized visual and what is a perspective as part of this personalized visual. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.